Man, explain to me. Explain to me, because I read somewhere and I've heard that the Laker situation. Explain to me exactly what you meant when you made those comments to that station in Arizona.
Well, I'm not even gonna say what I meant. I'm gonna tell you exactly what I said. That was a small little radio station, I guess, in Tucson, and the way they try to mix my words up is saying that I said, my son's only going to play for the Lakers. Now, why would I say that? My guy just wants to get to the league. It doesn't matter what team he plays for. I would love him to play for the Lakers. That's what I told him. I said, my son's going to be a Laker. I said, because I'm lucky like that.
Well, and you feel like they're in a perfect spot where right. they're at, and they probably pick in the top four, and your son's talent probably will land him in the top four, and hopefully that pairing will be the Lakers.
Yes. I said like this too. He's going to be a Laker. I'm going to speak it into existence.
LeVar Ball's wish might come true with Lonzo going to the Los Angeles Lakers. Let me explain why real quick. Obviously, the Lakers are tanking, and all the mock drafts are saying Lonzo Ball is destined to be a part of the Lakers in the second or first pick in the draft, depending on what day it is, because they're always first or second. So, why would the Lakers want Lonzo Ball? Obviously, they have a point guard in D'Angelo Russell. D'Angelo Russell isn't the greatest point guard for the Lakers, and he's been fantastic, though, at the shooting guard position, which could be perfect for the Lakers if they can get a good ball handler. He could really spread out the floor and actually help out this team, because that's what they need. They need a guy that can control this game in the point guard position and really do his thing, and Lonzo Ball is probably the perfect guy for this team. With that being said, the Los Angeles Lakers rebuild will be done today in this video with Lonzo Ball. It's going to be a realistic one with the cap space and everything. We're not going to make dumbass trades and really be all here there and sign Kevin Durant. You guys get the idea of that, okay? We're going to have a little fun. We're going to be realistic. We're going to see what I can do with this Lakers team the best that to my ability, if that makes sense. This is going to be an experimental video with the type of editing that I'm going to be using, so hopefully you guys like it. If you guys don't, let me know down in the comment section down below. Thank you guys for watching, and enjoy the video. Right off the bat, we still got to do the NBA draft, so we'll have the 26th pick in the draft thanks to the Rockets, and since Harry Giles is injured, assuming he'll go into the draft no matter what, we're going to draft a guy in Harry Giles as the power forward spot. Here are some of our re-signings, though. All you guys can see is the young guys. I'm not going to re-sign Tarik Black because that's $6 million. I do not want the cap space. Also, right here, this is me officially putting D'Angelo Russell in the shooting guard position, and this is going to be a new change for the Los Angeles Lakers. Now, obviously, with the Los Angeles Lakers, we need a big boy. Mozgov wasn't too bad, but they overpaid him way too much for $17 million. With Alex Len, I don't know if this contract will be realistic. As I can see, a $10 million contract, but for now, in 2K-wise, we'll go with it because we do need a big boy for the cheap, and this is the best one. Alex Len, though, $4 million. It makes sense. He can rebound, and he has great inside scoring and a good presence down low, and that's exactly what the Los Angeles Lakers need, so it'd be the perfect fit for them, and I believe this would be a great move for the Lakers because it's young, and they could work with him at the same time. In the next move, we'll get a guy, Tim Hardaway Jr. He's had a small breakout year this year, and it'd be a perfect shooting guard position for a backup. Unless D'Angelo Russell starts falling off and doesn't perform as well as what he should be doing, then we put him in the starting position because he's been great in both areas for the Atlanta Hawks, and I think this would be a great place for the LA Lakers to pick up guy, Tim Hardaway Jr. So here's what the starting lineup is looking like with Lonzo Ball playing the point guard position, D'Angelo obviously shooting guard. We're going to put Tim Hardaway at the small forward position. He is 6'6", he can fit the position. I think that would be a great move, and you guys will see why in a second. Larry Nance will be the power forward, and then Alex Len will be the starting center for the LA Lakers. A very young starting lineup, but I think this team could probably work it out very nicely with a good coach in Luke Walton. Right here, I'll get more in depth of why I put this bench. Clarkson will be the point guard. He's been a great six man for the Lakers. I think that will be a great fit for him. Nick Young, shooting guard. He was starting this year, but he'll be drop down since they have gotten Tim Hardaway and D'Angelo Russell, but Nick Young's still a great shooting guard. Brandon Ingram, he could probably run the point, because if you guys don't remember, Brandon Ingram was actually running the point guard position with the Lakers earlier this season, the 2016 season, but it didn't work out too well, and it didn't run as well as what Luke Walton was expecting, but he did an okay job, so if needed, Brandon could be the great ball handler. Julius Randle, he's young. He's not the greatest starting power forward yet. He hasn't really grown to what he is yet, and it's been pretty rough for him so far in his career as of now. Then you got a guy, Timofey Mozgov. Like I said, Timofey Mozgov is a great center. He just got overpaid for what he's doing. If he got paid like 10 mil, 9 mil, it would be a great signing for the LA Lakers, but 17.5, 18, it's that you can't be doing that kind of stuff, man. Here's what the trade block is looking like for the Lakers. Obviously, you see it's all big contracts. You got Mozgov, who's getting $18, $19 million a year. You got Luol Deng, who's getting $17 million a year. And then you got Corey Brewer, who's getting $8 million in a one-year deal. So Corey Brewer is the least of our worries. But Luol Deng and Mozgov are a huge worry for us. And the reason I say that is because they got him for veteranship. And obviously, it's not working out well because they can't even score the damn ball in the basket. So these two boys need to get traded, and it's a must, man. It's a must. Mozgov could be a good trade for the right person or team, I should say. As you can see, the Suns, we took Alex Len from them, and they could use a guy Mozgov if Tyson Chandler starts to retire in the next few years. So, but another team is the Brooklyn Nets. Brooklyn Nets, we could trade him over there too. And if we really just put in a draft pick for them, like a first round, maybe 2019 draft pick, the Nets will probably take that in a heartbeat just so they can get a draft pick since they're missing some in the next few years. Here are the Lakers as of right now. Not too bad. We're just two games under 500. Don't ask me about the Warriors. I don't know what is up with that. KD and all of the gang is still in that team right there. So probably an injury happened, but nonetheless, the boys are doing good. Two games under 500, that's better than last year or this year already. And the young man Lonzo doing work out there. 16 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists. What the steal a game. Not too shabby from the guy from the Lakers. Good pickup so far, as what it seems. He's actually ahead of the leaderboards right now for Rookie of the Year, which is great for the Lakers. Look at that. Even 2K knows that the Lakers, as they put D'Angelo at the shooting guard position, he'll be better. 20 points. Look at that. 4 rebounds, 5 assists. He's doing it all, man. That's a great performance by D'Angelo. A great breakout year for him. Lonzo, 16 points. We went through that. Brandon Ingram putting up 12 points. So I guess him being on the bench definitely benefited him. Jordan Clarkson on the bench as well. So Clarkson and Ingram could be the dynamic duo on the bench, with D'Angelo and Lonzo being the dynamic duo on the starting lineup. That could be a perfect fit right there, and I would love to see that the Lakers could handle that. To end the season, Lonzo Ball wins Rookie of the Year. That's great to see from a Laker right there. Lakers do finish off 4 games under 500 and barely miss the playoffs as a 9th seed, which sucked for them. And we look at statistics. D'Angelo Russell did fantastic. Actually improved to 22 points a game, and everyone else maintained at what they were. So D'Angelo at the shooting guard position was definitely a must for the Lakers at this simulation. But that is it, folks. Lakers don't make the playoffs. They make the 9th seed. Tim Hardaway Jr. did okay for what he was on the Lakers as a starting small forward, excuse me. And then Alex Len, he wasn't the starting center at the end of the day. Zubac actually decided to take over. I don't know why 2K did that, but that was the only position change that happened during this little simulation right here. So Zubac over Alex Len. Interesting move right there, but Alex Len didn't do as great as what I thought he would, but Tim Hardaway did okay. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys kind of like this editing style. I'm kind of interested to see how this turns out myself, but yeah, guys, thank you guys for all the support lately in the month of March. We gained over 35 subscribers in this month, and we've gotten over 25,000 views at one point, which is absolutely phenomenal. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out, everybody.